going on, everybody? This is Matt Does Fitness, and there's no I in denial. That's kind of my slogan. Right, as you can see on the screen there, today was squat day. That's a lie, it was actually Monday, but I'm just trying to make it sound more catchy. Squat-wise, it was 5 sets of 5, as has been the case the last 2 sessions. I'm making that my regular session now. 5 sets of 5, 155 kilos, 354 pounds. The weight has gone up, and I smashed it. I'm finding these 5 sets of 5 pretty friggin' tough in terms of the gym's hot, I'm sweating out, I'm feeling sore, my quads are being like annihilated, but at the same time, I feel like it's effective and it's definitely working. I'm feeling really strong. You see there, I am getting all kinds of depth and all kinds of stretch reflex action. I've kind of abandoned like the just barely breaking parallel. In case you hadn't noticed, I'm literally hitting full depth every squat. And initially it was hard, but now it's starting to feel comfortable and I feel like I'm getting loads of quad engagement and activation. I'm also getting a really nice kind of bounce off my my hamstrings, off my calves. And today was the first time where it really felt like that kind of stretch reflex, that bounce was starting to kind of click into place. Quite a few of the reps, I felt really tired, but I hit that kind of bounce and I felt like I was flying up, even though I felt, you know, pretty fatigued and like I didn't have much in me. So hopefully, as that gets even more kind of drilled in, it obviously bodes well when I get really heavy. I said I got all the reps. That's a lie, I didn't say that, but I didn't get all 5 sets of 5. The 5th set, I was pretty wiped out at that point. Like I said, I'm in the gym, I've said it loads of times, I always wind you out. The gym is very, very hot. So doing 5 sets of 5 is pretty hardcore. By the 5th set, I was pretty tired, so you'll see in a minute, I don't get all 5 reps, but the rest of the reps, all the other 4 sets were complete, and I felt really, really strong. A little side note on my belt, a few people have commented on it. My belt is quite old, it's not the best, I mean it does the job, but it's pretty rubbish. It leaves like crap all over my top every time I take it off. It's also a prong belt, which I don't like because when I try and pull it tight, A, it's like a separate workout in itself because I have to like work really hard to pull it tight, and B, I feel like it always pinches my skin, or a lot of the time it pinches my skin, which is really uncomfortable, obviously, and I get marks all over my stomach. So I do want to get a new one. I'm on the lookout. I mean, the ones I've seen seem to be 60 or 70 pounds, which for me is pretty ridiculous for a belt. I did see an RDX one in the sale for 30 pounds, but the smaller size it has was a medium, which is 32 to 36 inches. My waist, I think, is about 31 or so, so obviously that's too big for me, which is irritating, so I have to keep on looking. But like I said, to be honest, I'd rather carry on with my belt than fork out 60 or 70 quid on a new one, because it just seems, I don't know, like, unless I'm missing something, it is essentially a piece of fabric with, like, a little buckle on it. It seems pretty stupid to be charging £70. I don't really feel like I should be paying that. When I got a mortgage and those kind of things to pay for. Anyway, so this is my 5th set. This is where I don't get all 5. I mean, the first 1 or 2 reps in every set, I felt really explosive and really bouncy. I was coming up nicely. There's my 3rd rep. The 4th rep, I should have kind of seen it as a warning sign. You see here, pretty big grinder, but I'm not very good at kind of seeing sense. I went for a 5th rep and I bailed out. Now, that was possibly the slowest, most pathetic bailout of all time. I kind of really slowly jumped out of there, but I'm so used to doing those little kind of bails that it's kind of second nature. I don't really even think about it. I just kind of get that split second where I know I'm not going to get it, and I just kind of jump out. And to be honest, it's pretty safe. Anyway, I then dusted myself down and moved on to some front squats. I did 3 sets of 3, beltless at 115 kilos, 200 and... blah, 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 42 pounds, I think, or 50, I don't know, something like that, about 250. To be honest, my kind of grip, the way I'm holding the bar, is still comfortably my limiting factor. I feel like the squat comes up reasonably well, but it's the position of my arms. I toyed around with trying the kind of crossover grip, but it still didn't feel very comfortable, so I will need to get to grips with that before I can go really heavy, but I'm just doing it as an accessory, and they feel pretty friggin' good. Okay, moving on, accessory work, isolation work. I did, I don't know what this is called, like a straight arm kind of, I don't know, shoulder adduction or something. I did 3 sets of about 12 of these. I saw Mark McQueen doing them recently, so I thought I'd give them a go. I've tried them once before a long time ago, but haven't done them recently. I felt some pretty nice lat and general back engagement, to be fair. I did feel a little bit more tricep engagement than I probably should have done. I probably should have gone a little bit of a wider grip, but that attachment was on the bar, the cable, and I was kind of was in a bit of a lazy, sweaty mood, so I left it there. I then did some wide grip pull-ups, as is the norm for me now, trying to get that kind of wide grip strength up. I thought I'd use a nice zoomed out camera so you could enjoy the wondrous view that is my gymnasium. I did three sets of, I think, about 14 to about 12 to about 10 or so. I think this is the last set you're seeing here, which is why I'm struggling pathetically. I then did some dumbbell rows. I don't do these that frequently because I've said it before, I am pretty lazy, and because obviously they are unilateral, you have to do them one side at a time. I like to do things that kind of hit both sides simultaneously, but I went for these. I did three sets of 12 down to about 8, I think. I went reasonably heavy. They felt pretty good. By that point, I was kind of like a real sweaty mess. I just wanted to kind of get out of there. So I finished the session off with this kind of preacher curl machine. I'm not a massive fan of it. I'm not going to preach about it. It's a little bit wonky, so I feel like it kind of hits the left side a little bit more, which is not ideal, but that was that. I did four sets of about 12 reps, and that was my session, guys. So, hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, as always, and buy some t-shirts, and I will see you in my next video tomorrow.